It's the kind of work even the sheriff admits is risky.
You tell me.
Going undercover in Memphis and Shelby County.
You gonna meet with him?
To catch criminals in the act.
But if it goes well, if he's very comfortable with me, then I'm gonna try to buy whatever they'll sell me.
It's what members of the county's new street crimes unit do almost every day. They develop sources, meet with them, and then get the evidence they need to hopefully stop another drug buy, weapons sale, or murder from happening. It doesn't immediately start on the streets, but begins in the office.
How much you want to do, 100?
An informant claims to have information police can use to come down on some dope dealers. The undercover officer is briefed and agrees to meet with the informant.
Talking about probably the location, possible people in the house, weapons, danger.
In this case, the meeting appears to go well.
What are we looking like?
The undercover officer, or UC, tells the team leader he thinks the source may come through. And sure enough,
this is crack cocaine.
It's a successful undercover drug buy. So the street crimes unit plans a takedown.
Got a door here. This is our target door.
Developing an operational plan that gets street crimes officers in and out safely with suspects.
Here we go.
The Frazier duplex where the undercover says he bought crack from earlier that day.
This is where they were coming serving us.
Nothing but a dope house.
They did just like that and got up out of here.
The search also uncovers a secret passageway leading to the vacant side of the duplex.
Police!
You can see where they've been moving back and forth in a couple shotgun shells. SKS magazine.
Like in this case, the Shelby County Street Crimes Unit says the majority of the informants it relies on for information have criminal pasts. Gotcha. They quickly make two arrests with plenty of evidence bagged from the scene and find a suspect with previous warrants. But all street crime cases aren't quite this smooth.
There they go.
They can get bumpy, like in this high-speed chase.
He rammed us.
Put your seatbelt on.
Headed west on Summer, we need some help.
He's about to bail.
On this night, a convicted felon and burglary suspect out on parole shows police he isn't ready to go back to jail.
We just passed Cooper.
The suspected burglary ringleader, Marcellus Mason, breaks away from them.
We lost him at Lamar and South Parkway.
Police lose him near the airport. But unwilling to let the suspect go another night on the run, street crimes doesn't stop. They keep looking for leads.
Next office, open the door. Get on the ground, face first, let him move.
Two apartment complexes later.
Is there any weapons that you know that he has?
They get the information they need.
Number 9.
Their man's hiding in Hickory Hill.
We finally got the good source that led us to this address to where he was. As soon as we entered the house, Marcellus was seen laying on the foyer floor.
The arrest means the chase is over. After a day-long search, information collected by street crimes has paid off once again. But Sheriff Luttrell is quick to point out, not every lead is reliable.
The information that they give you is information that has to be corroborated. Then you kind of use that to build other evidence or to lead you into other areas.
He rammed us. We need some help.
They're just as smart as we are. They're as good at getting away from us.
Put seatbelt on.
As we are catching them.
Go.
You know, this is their business.